dropped off at the curb just outside the federal courthouse. Catherine Pugh made a brisk entrance, protected by lawyers. She went to court having signed a plea agreement even before the indictment against her was announced yesterday. This afternoon, in a crowded courtroom, Pugh pleaded guilty to 4 of the 11 counts filed against her by a federal grand jury. They include conspiracy to commit wire fraud, conspiracy to defraud the United States, and 2 counts of tax evasion. Pugh now admits she defrauded the buyers of her Healthy Holly children's books, including the University of Maryland Medical System, and used the money to fund her 2016 mayoral campaign and finance the cash purchase of her house. She also admits cheating on her taxes. In court, she answered the judge's question, saying she was pleading guilty because she is guilty. She made no comment as she left.
Anything to say, Mayor Pugh?
Would you like to say anything?
The city of Baltimore faces many pressing issues, and we need dedication and professionalism from our leaders, not fraud and corruption, if we have any hope of fixing these problems.
Prosecutors dropped a new detail today, saying in 2015, Pugh took a $100,000 check to a bank window and cashed it in order to hide the income on her taxes. Banks must report large cash transactions.
And in this case, the bank did follow those rules and regulations.
Did it report it?
The bank did comply with rules and regulations.
Also today in court, prosecutors identified one of the book buyers who knew his money was actually going to Pugh's campaign. They identified him as J.P. Grant, a big city contractor. A short time ago, Catherine Pugh's attorneys issued a statement. In part, the statement reads, "This has been a challenging process for former Mayor Pugh. After careful consideration, Ms. Pugh has decided to forego a long trial, which would drain government resources and cause further distraction from the serious issues our region faces." It goes on, Ms. Pugh sincerely apologizes to all of those she's let down, most especially the citizens of Baltimore, whom she had the honor to serve for decades. Again, that is a statement from Pugh's attorney. The sentencing guidelines agreed to both sides in this plea agreement put her sentence at about 5 years, but the judge is very free to determine her own length of time. Reporting live tonight from the federal court, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.